Yo, yo, oh no, no, no. Yo, Melvitto, boss little. Hey loves, it's Adanna here and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, we're back here again with this butterfly locks. However, this one is completely different from the last one. The method, this one is a lot easier, it's a lot quicker, there's no wrapping, and of course it's going to last longer because our natural hair is not going to be out. You know what I mean? So like all of our natural hair is going to be tucked in, your hair is going to be protected. Just a perfect, quick and easy protective style for this winter season. So starting off with my hair is actually currently stretched out because I had it in these cornrows for like over 1 week. So my hair is pretty stretched out. And to start off this hair, so I'm going to be doing some single plaits here at the back. We had about 7 strands of single braids here at the back, and then we're going to be doing some single plaits here in front as well. We're going to be doing the crochet method, however we're not going to be doing like the individual, we're going to be doing the cornrow, the individual cornrow in the cornrow. What am I saying this morning? The individual cornrow method. So we're going to have the cornrows, but it's going to look like individuals, give you that illusion of individual crochet braids without having to do the individual work, you know, just the escape routes. So that's what we're going to be doing today. No tucking of any natural hair, no wrapping, none of that. It's just going to be very easy to install and it's still going to come out looking very natural. Okay, so this particular entire crochet braid pattern was inspired by Beauty Can Braid here on YouTube. I just love this braid pattern. It's so easy and it's just so perfect. Even if you can't even control, you don't even need a skill of doing cornrows. All you need to do is just know how to do like single plaits for this hairstyle and you'll be ready with your protective style in less than 2 hours, okay? So once we're done putting the front and back of our natural hair in single plaits, we're just going to move on to the middle section. For this middle section, as you all can see right now, I didn't really try to make it to be so perfect. I didn't use any shine and jam gel to hold my natural hair together like I was doing for the front and back. I literally just freestyled this middle part and I just braided my natural hair up until I didn't even have to finish it because I'm going to end up twisting everything together anyways. So once that whole middle section is done and we're done with the entire single plait, all I basically did to join this hair together was just to flat twist the hair, like flat twist the single plaits in such a way that you're just grabbing each plait as you're going and then twisting it. And then for the back, I flat twisted it upwards just so in case I want to put my butterfly locks up in a ponytail, I will be able to do that and it will still look natural. I didn't want to have like all the bulky ends of my hair, like all the bulky ends of my natural hair to be at the back. I wanted all the bulky ends of our natural hair to be in the middle, just like I said. So in that way, if you want to do your hair in ponytail, if you want to put your butterfly locks in any style, it would still look like individual, you know, it still have that individual illusion from the front or from the back or from the side, okay? And now that we'll be able to join all of those single plaits, we're just going to go ahead right now to flat twist and tuck in the rest of the ends of our natural hair using the crochet hook. And then moving on to the fun flying part of this video, this is the butterfly locks installation. I'm going to be using this pre-distressed butterfly locks from Niseyo Hair on Amazon. This actually comes in a pack of 6. However, I ended up using just 4 bundles of this entire head. 4 bundles was perfectly enough. It was full and it was just the perfect quantity like I wanted it to be. And this is also in 12 inches and it's in color 1B. Start off with this entire crochet butterfly installation. We're just going to go ahead to grab the hair extension. The loop of the where the crochet needle is supposed to pass through, the loop is actually quite small. So you have to take your time to swirl it to open up that loop prior to you going ahead to install this onto your natural hair plaits. One thing you also want to take note of is when doing your individual plaits, you want to make sure that you're not doing it too tight at the roots of your natural hair, just because if you're
individual plaits are too tight, then it's going to be a little bit difficult for this crochet hair to pass through. So you don't want to put that much tension on your hair. So try to make sure that your individual plaits are not too tight. So right now, going through this entire process together, we're just going to go ahead to start off with our open crochet hook. Grab the extension and pass it through our natural hair plaits. And then go ahead to grab the end of this crochet extension, just like so. Grab the ends right there. Close up the hook after grabbing it, just so it doesn't hook up to something else. And then pass it through this little hole and then just slightly pull it out with your hand. When pulling this crochet extension through the hole, you want to make sure that you're taking your time and just being gentle, just so you don't obstruct like the, you know, the butterfly effect, just so it doesn't become fuzzy. So just make sure that once you're pulling it through, you're taking your time to gradually, step by step, slowly pull the extension through the hole. So we're just going to repeat this exact same process again, just so we can make sure that we're carrying everyone along. On your crochet hook, we're going to go ahead to pass this through our natural hair plaits. You want to make sure you're passing the crochet hook at the section where you actually plaited your hair, so not in the joints cornrow line, not there. You want it to look like box braids. So you're going to make sure that you're putting the extension, you're installing this crochet extension on the individual plait itself, like on the root of those, not on the lines, but on the root of those. It gives it that more of a natural look, so it looks like it's coming from that particular braid, if that makes sense. And then for this entire styling process, I wanted to go for like a side part. It all depends on you. You could also freestyle this and do a free parting. I wanted to go for a side part, so you all will see me changing the position of the way I'm doing installing the crochet hair, just so everything falls on the sides. So for this side right now, I'm just going to install the crochet hook from your left hand, chuck it upwards towards your right side. So in that way, it's going to allow the hair to fall down towards my left on this side. And then for the other side, we're installing it in the opposite direction. I hope that makes sense. I hope I'm not confusing you guys, but basically just trying to make sure that everything is falling in the side that you want it to fall. And for this one, like I said, I was going for a side part, so I wanted the loop on this side to fall towards the left and the loop on the other side to fall towards the right. So grabbing your crochet hook again, we're going to pass this through our natural hair plait at the root of where the plait actually starts from for that particular section that we're working on. And then we're going to go ahead right now to grab the end of this crochet hair and then gently pass this through this loophole. You don't want to obstruct the entire butterfly, so just take your time to gently pass this through. And this is basically for this hairstyle, y'all. This hairstyle was so quick to achieve. Last few touch-ups that I did, which is personal preference, I just went ahead to cut the ends of some of the extensions at the back. You all know this entire hair extension is in 12 inches, so I kind of felt like the back was a little bit too long, and I'm not really a fan of like the layered look. I prefer my, you know, my locks and my braids to kind of all be at least about the same length, but I found that some of them were a little bit too long. So all I basically did was just to cut that end to the length that I felt it was perfect, cut with the scissors, and then grab my flame and just lighted it up there and just use my lighter to burn the ends just to secure this entire extension back to its original state. You don't want to leave it unraveled because your butterfly will leave. You don't want the butterflies to go. So make sure that if you're cutting your ends of your hair, please secure it with some form of heat. Okay? And that's basically for this hairstyle, y'all. And as always, I had to, you know, I went ahead to accessorize my hair. Alright, I hope you all enjoyed this video and it was helpful for those of us that don't really want to go through the hassle of wrapping our butterflies to be locking. I hope you all enjoyed it. Thumbs up if you did. Comments. Let me know if you tried the crochet version of butterfly locks. And if you've already tried the original one, let me know down below as well. And I'll see you all in my next one. Have a lovely rest of your weekend. Bye.